This is Talk Lion coming to you live from Las Vegas, where I'm always on some type of motherfucking bullshit. In today's bullshit, we're going to get to the whitewashing of black history in America. And not just in America, but all over the world. But we're going to start with watching. They had a busk revealing, which was the Nefertiti busk. And it's supposed to be spot on, like they said. But this is another bunch of bullshit from what talked and seen, whitewashing black history. Now, take a good look at it. This was done on the Today Show. Check it out. This is Nefertiti. Change. Once again, here we go. We're going to get our power build up like we always do on the talk show.
What was the inspiration for doing this?
You know, fucking black people is, I think, sadly remembered as the most beautiful woman of the
making
world.
The ass out of black people. That's the inspiration.
Really substantial leader. This is a woman who was a pharaoh, and I think that it's time to identify her, to figure out who she really was. We know her from this famous bust in Brunette that everyone sort of remembers her from.
When y'all
that's
get
a kind
ready.
Of idealized image. And so we wanted to look at this mummy in the Egyptian Museum and say, could this be the real Nefertiti?
All right, so we're going to reveal it, but this is 3D imaging. You think this is spot
see,
on?
This is spot
behind
on. This was a 3D right. image of the mummy's head was done. It was then given to a forensics team and an incredible world-class reconstruction artist. So this is very accurate.
All right, here it comes. We're going to
reveal.
I'm ready.
Here we go.
Roll,
two, three.
Wow.
And there she is.
Wow. Wow, that's intense.
Wow.
Isn't she amazing?
Yes. She really is.
So how did it reconstruct? And how accurate do you think this is?
I think it's extremely accurate
like
to the mummy. The forensics artists are able to do an extremely good job at looking at the tissue, depth, determining muscle,
good
and
job,
all of that.
Huh?
And so what we're looking at here for sure is King Tut's mother. We know genetics.
Hold it, though. He just said for sure. Now, you know damn well this lady don't look shit like Nefertiti. Shit like her. Take a good look at her. Look at the nose and look at the lips. There's no way Nefertiti would look shit like this. This is a nose of a woman that would not have a backside. When I mean Nefertiti was known not just to be the beautifulest woman in the world in history, she also had a backside that they made a busk of her because she had her ass on her. And look at the nose on this chick. That's why they bust the real Nefertiti nose also, you never notice. Wide lips. Don't look nothing like this lady right here. But we're going to continue the video. We're going to continue watching the whitewashing of black history. And Talk going to give you, man, we're going to break this shit down. Get back to the video. Here we go.
This mummy is King Tut's mother.
So Nefertiti.
That's right. We know that. We know that
history,
Tut's father
y'all.
Was Akhenaten, who was married to Nefertiti.
His story, let him
he's
tell.
He's a good bet. And the really encouraging thing for me is that when you look at the known ancient
Streisand
images of Nefertiti that we have, like the Berlin bust, there are amazing similarities.
See, white
here.
People doing the
say,
study. Look at that. They're putting the bust together. Should have been somebody black doing it, I think.
They sell them everywhere in Cairo, and it looks spot on.
But
yeah.
Spot on. Really is that the
now, look
Berlin
at the white man standing up there beside Nefertiti.
Sort of
just like a,
right.
Look at the black lady, and that's a light-skinned black
woman. And when you look at this reconstructed bust, what we see here is someone who
she don't look shit like Nefertiti.
And someone whose mummy was really
who
hacked
is
off.
This
and now
bitch.
We can really see her restored.
Definitely ain't Nefertiti. Who is this
that
bitch?
That's cool.
Incredible artistry.
Hold that though. We had enough of that. Now let Talk finna break it down for you. And then we're gonna get to the Flintstones. First of all, we want to talk about Black History Month because we tired of shit like this here happening. You know, we get this in Black History Month, but Talk gonna end Black History Month like it should be ended. You damn right, let's end it for good. We through with Black History Month. We don't want it no more. We don't have a White History Month because we got a White History Year. We had a White History Decade. We had a White History Period. But we predate white people. So why do we gotta be the first? Every time somebody black, I just watched the new black NASCAR lady. You're damn right. We always gotta be the first black to do this here. When we predate white history by thousands and thousands and thousands of years. You're damn right. Black people, you know when they say the evolution from ape to caveman? You know, that's history, y'all. I learned that in school. I learned history in school. From the evolution from ape, you know, and then he ended up walking and all that. I learned that in school. They made sure we learned that. But that's right. That's history. We should learn that. It's his story. And we're going to get to the Flintstones now. Also, we got to clear this myth up. And white people, listen to me real good. Y'all know this already. But I want black people to tune in. Get your ears up here close. The black man and woman never had an ice age. Oh, that was deep. That's rewriting history right there. You damn right. You know we never had an ice age. Y'all had an ice age. That's why we call it history. His story. But he want to group everybody in and say everybody came on the earth at the same time. But he know that when the ice age was over, when all the ice melted, the pyramids were standing. You damn right. Now, they might have had the noses. They might have got down there and knocked the noses off because they know this. We are noticing that everything in history that's been hidden is black. Now, they done been to the moon. They done put a man on the moon, supposedly. But they got paleontologists down there. They've been digging in Africa and Egypt for I don't know how long, studying black history. They know all about us. They know who built them pyramids. But if they ever give you that, if they ever say that, you know, the black man built the pyramids, then they wouldn't have never been able to rule over you like this. That's right. They taking Nefertiti and turning her white just like they did Jesus. You damn right. They screwed us over with the image of Jesus. They stole that from us. We know what Jesus looked like. Just like right now, they still in Egypt right before our eyes. There's no way in the world a woman this light. You see the pyramids back there. There's no way in the world unless she stayed inside the pyramids all the time. You damn right. They digging right now, studying black history. They know all about us, but they want to try and act like we came up in the Stone Age. You better wake up, black man, and pull your goddamn pants up. Now, let's get to the Flintstones. You know, you remember Fred and Barney, the cavemen. You know what I'm saying? We never was cavemen, but it was one of my favorite cartoons, the Flintstones. You understand that? We was never cavemen. We never had an ice age. When the ice melted and the first people finally came out from under the ice and came and looked, they looked and was like, Oonga Boonga, when they saw the pyramid. What the fuck is that? Oonga Boonga. They couldn't even speak. They saw the pyramids there. So how was we in the ice age? We had civilizations. We was building shit that they can't even figure out today. Right now today, 2018. You can get the same group of white people and stand them out in front of the pyramids, but you can understand what they saying now. They saying, who built this and how they did it? Well, they know who built it, but they can't tell you how it was done, just like they couldn't tell in the Stone Age when they came out from under the ice. They couldn't tell you how that shit got there. But they damn sure knew that they had to steal it by any means necessary. We got to say that we built this. If not, we cannot rule over black people all these years. That's right, black man. I'm going to let you know something else, black man. We the greatest fighting machine that was ever created by God was black. Check out throughout history when they was, you know, when they was in the ice age somewhere, froze. We had civilizations. Check out the new movie, Black Panther. They finally revealing black history to you. Check out the movie, Black Panther. You're going to find out about some of the great black civilizations. The richest man on the planet, King Musa. You damn right, was a black man. But I just saw a couple of weeks ago that some white dude, I can't think his name, they say he the richest man on the planet. But King Musa was the richest man ever, but they don't count black history because they start with white history. Now, that's why I said, when you watch the Flintstones next time, you see Fred and Barney Rubble, and you'll notice why you never see any black people in the original cartoon. They didn't have black people. They didn't count us because they know damn well we wasn't in no goddamn caves with them. You're damn right. That's why. I think they made a Flintstone movie. I think they threw a few black people in that end because they knew damn well that it was some motherfucking bullshit they was on. But they, hey, keep it real. The Flintstones was real. No black people. Bedrock. You damn right. Check it out. Check it all out. We wasn't no cavemen. We didn't grab our women by the hair and drag them with something bad in our hand. This is Talk Lion. And I'm always on some type of motherfucking bullshit. That's right. Peace.